Hey everybody, Von here with the Vonster vlog, and welcome to day 190 of a year of yoga. I still don't really have a plan for today, but as usual, we're probably going to want our blocks. We may be doing some stuff with a strap. I don't know just yet, but we'll grab it just in case, because why not? Let's start off with some balance work today. Thank you guys so much for joining me here. Let's start in the center of our mat, spreading our toes nice and wide and planting them into the ground. Really balancing between the inner and outer balls of our feet and on our heels. So it's a little tripod of support. And it's actually, I'm going to shift off of a squeaky board. With bending our knees, let's make a bit of a circle. And it doesn't have to be paired with your breath. Actually, take as long and as deep of a breath as you can. And then exhale. Let's exhale through our nose. Change direction. You can exhale through your mouth if you like. Then we're going to practice just like a cat making biscuits on a plush blanket. Just as we lift our foot from the ground, we'll push through to the tips of our toes. And this is going to help to kind of stretch and warm up all that connective tissue. We can also be making figure eights with our hands and wrists. Change direction with your hands, but keep going with your feet. And you can lift your knees up nice and high too. From here, let's ground down through our right foot. Take a few breaths here to really center yourself over it. I like to keep a little bit of a bend in my knee because it gives me room to make micro adjustments as I'm trying to maintain my balance. And inhale, we can bring our toe off the ground and then turn our knee open into tree pose. And if you're ready, you can actually lift your arms overhead, growing like the branches of a tree. And when you're ready, come on out of it. Shift our weight over to the left. Really putting that weight down, grounding through our left foot, raising our right toe, opening that right knee. And when you're ready, exit out of that pose with some nice control. Let's step now to the foot of our mat. Inhale, arms up overhead. And exhale, forward fold. I have my knees about shoulder width apart, or my feet shoulder width apart. And you can bring your hands to a block or to the ground or just wherever you feel you're getting the most out of this hamstring stretch. And let's shift our weight from side to side.
Just moving with our breath. Crazy dog. I see that tail wagging.
Oh, yeah, it's a good a stretch and a bend, huh, buddy? He says, yoga's better when you grunt, Mom. That's true. So let's inhale, come up to a flat back. And exhale. Let your head and shoulders hang. And from here, I'm actually going to reach forward and grab my strap. And I'm going to put it quite wide so that it's one big loop. And I'm going to bring my hands up behind me. Just threading them both through the loop of my strap. And I'm actually just looping my thumbs through to give myself more space. Raise your hands behind you as though you're growing long through your fingertips. It's not just about getting your arms up behind you, it's that outward growth of them. Make sure that you're breathing. That is an exceptionally challenging stretch for me, so I just do it a bit. But a bit is better than none. Let's put our feet nice and wide. And come on down into a garland pose. We can shift from side to side until we get our foot alignment correct. Perhaps bringing our heels to the ground if we're able to. And you can use a block in front of you to put your hands on as well to help you keep and maintain your posture going up and out. We can actually use that same block put between our hands and raise our hands over our head. To try to maintain that integrity and posture through our upper body as well. Touching the ground with our fingertips, let's push on up through. I'm going to put my feet just a little wider. I'm going to set that block off to the side. Keeping our hands on the ground or one hand on each block if you benefit from that. Inhale and exhale. Come on down. Inhale our arms up. Exhale our fingertips down. That's one. Okay. We'll inhale and exhale, pressing up. Inhale, press down. Inhale, exhale, arms up. Inhale, bring your arms down and exhale up. I feel like I can't get the same breath sequence twice, but just keep breathing. Keep moving with your breath. Come on down into our third squat. And from here, let's bring our toes in closer together. Walk our hands out into a plank. Inhale and exhale, downward facing dog. We can shift our weight from side to side, really getting into the back of our legs here. Pushing the ground away from ourselves with our hands. Inhale and come on down, bringing your knees to the mat. Let's press on back to child's pose. Come on up. I'm going to walk my knees forward just a bit. And then sit up into thunderbolt position. And from here we can lean back, bringing our hands to the mat, stretching through the fronts of our shoulders, across our chest, and engage your glutes, and that's going to get really nice and deep into our quadriceps. So as I inhale, I disengage my glutes and lift my chest, focusing on my shoulders. And as I exhale, tuck those glutes, bring your navel in, push into those quads. And come on up out of that, and let's shift around to cobbler's pose. That stretch is very intense for me. I think I should focus on maybe doing, stretching my quadriceps and my shoulders separately, but I also really enjoy that posture because it's a balance of intensity. There's equal upper body and lower body stuff going on. And as we sit here, just observe your breath. Savor it. I feel like all week I have been very high strung and very just fearful. There's a fear that takes hold whenever you feel like you have what you've worked for, and to feel afraid of losing it. And it's the tighter you grip, the faster the sand sifts through the sieve. So it's important to let go and just be in the moment, savoring. Sometimes there's parts of the river, if we're sitting on the shore, watching the thoughts go by. There's parts of the river that are slow and lazy and warm. And sometimes I don't want to sit on the shore and watch the thoughts float by. Sometimes I want to just lay in the water and float with it. Let's do that today. So as you're sitting on the shore, watching the water flow by, carrying thoughts and worries and concerns and ideas and dreams and memories and everything good and bad and everything in between, just flowing by. You can stand up and shed the parts of you that you feel like might sink you down to the bottom of that river. And you can visualize it like removing articles of clothing, like taking your shoes off, putting your phone and your wallet and your keys, and your glasses, if you're like me. And so you can get as particular about the shedding of these mundane and sometimes heavy things. Until you are at a comfortable layer of clothing, or lack thereof entirely, and walk into the water. And take note of if the water is warm, or if it's cool, or if it's cold. I remember playing in the creeks and stuff as a kid, and the top would always, like the top like foot or so of water would always be kind of warm, but man, it could get chilly down in the depths. And just relax into the water. And let the gentle current carry you. Just feel the tension seeping out of you, washing away. All of your fear, all of your anger, all of your doubt. Start to bring your awareness back to your breath when you're ready. Pull in a nice, extra deep breath. Let it swirl within you. And start to wiggle your fingers and your toes. And I'm actually going to start shifting around and making, we're going to start small with the circle that we make. As we sit here, you could be in easy pose, you could be in bound angle or cobblers. Let's actually try this in easy pose. No, I like it better in cobblers. Yeah, we'll be coming to the left, front, right. And we'll inhale across the front, exhale as we scoop through the back. You can put your hands on your knees to help you stretch through, pulling forward. Just a few more in this direction. Change direction. So our spine can be going in the same movement patterns as when we're practicing cat-cow. But I find myself making smaller movements. It's there and it's similar, but it's smaller, it's much more internal. And then also just the fun and joy of, woo. I love going through the front on that. Woo. And you can get your abs as involved as you like. So, like, as we come to the back, pulling in on our abs and coming forward, really releasing forward. Okay, now from here, let's roll our shoulders up and back. Once, twice, and thrice. Then forward, up and back. Oh, really nice and deep neck circles. We can put our legs out nice and wide. Not too wide, like, but we want to feel a stretch. And we can, while we breathe, and the movement does not have to be paired with your breathing, but it is important that you do keep breathing. We can just reach from one foot to the other. And as we get there, let's reach just a little farther. Now let's hold on to our lower shins or our ankles or even our toes. And start just reaching and relaxing forward. We can grab a block and put a block under each elbow to relax forward into this pancake posture. You can inch your blocks just a little farther forward. And while we're here, I'm going to kind of squeeze in on my knees enough that I can lift my feet. I'm not locking my knees, but it's a muscle there. And it's giving us enough room that we can make circles with our feet. One. In the other direction, 2, 3, 4, 5, and relax. Inhale, straight back leaning. Exhale, bowing forward. And when you're ready, come on up out of that. Feel free to continue stretching whatever calls to you for a need that it needs stretched. Go ahead and stretch it. Maybe continue practicing your breathing and visualization. I got a whole rest of my day of work ahead of me, and I'm going to go tackle it with a smile in my heart and just float with the flow of the river. Enjoying the sun on my face. Not the literal sun, not just because it's dark outside, because I get sunburned. Just a little, like the figurative one, the one that doesn't sunburn me. Thank you guys again so much for joining me here and for taking the time out of your day to make time for yourself. So I will see you guys again tomorrow for another day of a year of yoga. So until then, you guys, keep on keeping on. Bye.